Your ride's here.
Coming! And I'll be back by 11:30, I promise.
If you're not back by 11:45, I send a search party.
Bye.
Hey, say hi to the gang for me.
You sure you don't want to go? We're going to Luke's after.
I'm positive.
No?
All right.
Bye, dear.
Bye.
Have a good time.
I will.
Bye.
Bye.
Have fun.
I will.
I make that same play in practice every time.
I bet.
I do. The coach says I might start next week.
Why do girls play basketball anyways?
Why do guys?
Same reason they play any sport in high school. To get girls.
Please!
Second half already started. Come on, Alex.
Hey, come on. Take it inside, huh?
I'm on probation as a kid. Hold on.
Over there in the middle.
Oh, man, it's packed. There's no seats.
Don't worry about it. Now, look out. Here comes the principal.
Hello, boys. Are you going to bring home a wrestling championship for Chester Saturday?
You can count on it.
Heard about the talk you gave to the freshman class last week. We're all very proud of it.
Well, thank you, Mr. Knight. Best way to scare kids off drugs is just tell them what I went through.
Excuse me. Me and my buddies want to squeeze in here?
But there's no room.
Oh, come on. Just give it a try. Excuse me.
Is he going to score yet?
Yeah. We're up by four.
Who's coming to this party tonight?
Usual folks. It's not going to be that big.
Are they ever?
What was it? Hey, Luke Larson's having a party. You can call it that.
Now let's get some beer first.
Yes! Drink up, Pete.
Chug.
Good one.
You are next.
Yeah, you won't be able to get it in.
Name on it. Here you go.
No way. I may be a little late. I haven't found a ride yet.
You want me to come and get you?
No, Dad, I can find a ride.
I can be there in 20 minutes.
I'll call you back.
I'll put on a football jersey. They'll think I'm your brother.
Goodbye, Dad. Lisa, I can't wait any longer. I need a ride now.
He hasn't asked me out yet.
I'll give you a ride.
No, that's okay.
She lives right down the street from me.
Yes, no problem.
Why can't you go with him?
I don't even know him.
His name's Alex, and he's all everything at Chester. If you don't go with him, I will.
Carrie, have you met Alex Kelly?
No. Hi.
Hi.
Listen, I can find a ride, really.
At 11:30, she turns into a pumpkin, so
it's no problem, really. I can drop you off and come back.
See, Carrie, when you're 17, you won't have this problem.
Assuming you know how to drive by then.
What's the rush?
She's got a curfew.
It's curfew.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Bye tomorrow.
It's just here.
Is this yours?
No, it's my girlfriend's parents. They're away in Florida. Let me drive it.
That's pretty nice of them.
What are you doing?
Oh, come on.
No, just take me home. Please.
Fine.
Wait, that's my house. You passed it.
I'll just go and turn around.
No, just let me out. I can walk.
No, that's all right. I'll just go and turn around. You're gonna make love to me, or I'll kill you.
Help!
Get in the back. Get in the back. Take your clothes off. Take your clothes off. This could be easier. This could be hard.
Why?
I don't know. I couldn't help myself.
If you tell anybody, I'll do it again. And then I'll kill you.
Harry, what's wrong?
Nothing. I had a fight with a girl from school. I can't talk about it.
Hi. Hey. Beer and painkillers are so sweet. How you feeling? I'm alive.
Hi, darling. How did the game go?
Oh, we won.
Great. Did you do anything interesting afterwards?
Not special.
You ready to go upstairs?
Yeah.
All right. Just lean on my arm.
There, you got it?
Did you go to bed? Put the lights up.
Tell me what I missed.
Oh, my God.
Carrie?
Oh, my God.
Carrie, what? What's wrong?
I can't.
Carrie? Carrie, what happened?
He said he'd kill me.
Who did?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Okay? It'll help. It'll help.
Okay.
What?
My back.
Oh, Gary. Okay, take your pants off.
Oh.
What? What? Oh, God. Okay, I'll be right back.
I don't know what to do, Andrew.
Well, where's Mom and Dad?
They're upstairs. They don't know anything. She won't let me tell them. I know, but she won't let me. Alex said he'd kill her, and she's terrified.
Who is that? What are you doing?
It's Andrew. Talk to him, please.
Hey, I'm so sorry. You all right?
No. That was so awful, Andrew. It's so awful.
But you gotta tell Mom and Dad.
I can't do that.
Okay. Then if it's all right with you, I'll tell them.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Hello?
Is this Joe Kelly, Alex's father?
I just got a call from Carrie Roberts' father. She told him that you raped her. Is that true?
What? Dad, are you kidding? No way. I don't even know her. I don't.
I talked to Alex and he denies it. How's your daughter doing?
Not well.
So, what are you gonna do?
Well, at this point, I'm not sure.
Carrie is extremely frightened because she says Alex threatened to kill her.
We're trying to convince Carrie to go to the doctor and the police.
Well, so be it.
Yes, so be it.
Joe, what was that all about?
Mark Roberts is saying that Alex gave his daughter a ride home last night and raped her. Alex denies it. You were asleep.
Oh, my God. Who's his daughter?
Carrie? I don't even think Alex knows her.
Wasn't even in the car with her.
That's a hell of a thing to make up, son.
Yeah, it sure is.
Oh, is it possible that she could have a crush on you?
I wouldn't be surprised. She certainly wouldn't be the first one.
Need to get you to a doctor.
No. Please, I don't want to.
I know. But he may have really hurt you internally. And those bruises.
I don't want to see Dr. Anderson.
No. No, you need to see a gynecologist. Well, Dr. Reston is very nice.
No!
Would you rather see a woman? I'll take care of that, all right?
go lie down.
The doctor said there was trauma to the genital area. Multiple cuts and scrapes. He really roughed her up. It's just that she's such a happy, outgoing kid. I mean, how is this going to affect her?
Are you safe?
Yes.
Yeah, I need to.
Somebody come on here.
Well, bring him with me upstairs.
You feeling better, honey? I know how hard this is, but we're almost done. If you can just give me...
You shouldn't have come here.
No. You made the right decision. Now, if you can sign a complaint, we'll bring him in.
I can't do that. He threatened to kill me. Do you know how close he lives?
Carrie, he can't get to you if he's behind bars.
I know, but I can't. I can't, Mom.
Take a couple of days to consider things, Miss Roberts. When you're ready, if you're ready, you can come in and sign a formal complaint, all right?
Bruce?
Kelly Mann on line one.
Hello?
Remember I phoned you the other day about a 16-year-old who said she'd been raped by Alex Kelly?
Oh, yeah, Carrie Roberts. Yes, did she decide to press charges?
No, but there's another girl claiming he just did the same thing last night.
It's my fault.
It is not your fault, Carrie.
But I could have stopped it. If I'd signed that complaint.
Honey, you couldn't possibly have known.
No. I can't let him do it again.
Hello, Carrie.
I'm ready to press charges against Alex Kelly. For rape. Honey, are you all right?
What?
Honey, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, Mom. I'm glad you both came.
I can only imagine how alone you must be feeling right now. Kind of like the world isn't a safe place anymore. It takes a lot of courage to go through something like this. But I want you to know that I'll be with you every step of the way. But I also want you to know that it is going to get rough. But I want you to try to remember, no matter how hard it gets, that I'm on your side.
What's it like to testify in court?
It's just like having a conversation. I ask you a question, you answer. No games, no rehearsed speeches, just you being yourself. Okay, let's talk about... Alex. Alex Kelly.
How long will he be in jail? Until the trial starts?
No. A week, perhaps. I did ask for an unusually high bail. Keep him in a little longer.
500,000? Why is it so high?
Well, given last year's difficulties of drug rehab, we don't have a lot of leverage, Alex.
Look, I feel terrible about all this. I mean, just when I thought I had all the bad stuff behind me, now this.
Darling, this is not entirely your fault. Chris took a lot of our attention, and I
take a lot of this blame, son.
I'm just worried they're going to use my past against me.
Well, honey, they don't know you the way we do. The truth will come out, I promise.
If everyone believes those girls, if I can't beat this thing.
But you will, son. You will. We've hired the best damn lawyer in the state.
Mickey Sherman. He's good.
And what do you think our chances are?
Well, we have two plaintiffs with the same story, and if the judge joins the cases together, I think we stand an excellent chance.
We'll get through this. I love you.
I love you too, Lynn.
I want to meet her. The other girl.
Well, I'm sorry, but I couldn't allow that.
Why not?
Because Mickey will say that you were comparing stories, that you had done this together. You're gonna have to trust me on this one.
I don't want to compare stories. I just want to apologize.
Can I tell you a little secret? I could have arrested Alex a few days ago. When I read your story in the police report, I could have impounded the Jeep, taken him in. But I didn't. I waited, just like you. So you see, we could either blame ourselves, or we can put him away. Together.
Can I speak to Carrie, please?
I'll see if she'll come to the phone. Who is it?
It's Alex Kelly. Please?
Now, you listen to me. Don't you ever dare to call here again. Do you understand me?
That was him, wasn't it?
Honey, it's all right.
He's gonna kill me. He said so.
Carrie, he is not. He's in jail.
For how long?
I don't know how to thank you, Mr. Sherman.
It's Mickey, and thank you, folks. They put up the house, not me.
I still can't believe any of this. I just can't wait to get back to school, get things back to normal.
Right. Yeah, about school, they'd prefer you to study at home for now. They'll provide it to you, just until things calm down a bit.
Doesn't that make me look guilty?
It won't be for long, son.
Morning.
Morning.
Are you going to school today?
No.
I have a math quiz for Spirit.
Should we look? Good luck. Are you?
Have a good day.
Honey, come on. You don't want to be late for Dr. Alonso.
Mom, where's the car parked?
Out front.
Can you pull it into the garage?
Oh, Carrie, it's just outside the front door.
Mom, he lives right down the street. Please.
Hey, you know, this reminds me of when we were kids. You know? Staying home on snow days.
Yeah. Weren't we drinking milk and cookies then?
Yeah. Probably for the last time. You know, I never thought I would miss being seven.
Yeah. Be nice to be a kid again. Have all those people cooing and fussing.
Hi. Coming in?
Alex, I can't go to the game with you.
You can't?
Alex, I can't see you anymore.
Since when?
My parents don't think it's a good idea. I'm sorry.
Erica, wait a second. Erica? Erica!
What's wrong with you?
I think Erica just broke up with me.
You mean just now?
Yeah, but I saw it coming.
So you gonna blow off basketball game tonight?
I don't know. It's gonna be weird being out.
So, where do you want to sit, boss?
Oh my God,
Ashley, I can't stop him from coming to a basketball game.
Well, you're not letting him back into school, are you?
We haven't made a final decision.
My sister still can't leave the house because of what he did to her, and you haven't made a decision.
Alex! 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 Alex!
Hi. Who won the game?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
Can I talk to you? I feel like we've become strangers. Like you're mad at me.
No, Ash. I've just been going through a lot. It's not you.
Are you sure? I mean, about that night. But I didn't go with you to the party.
Ash.
No, really. I think about it all the time. Whether you're angry with me for not going with you. Oh, Carrie. I'm so sorry. There's something else. It kills me to see you locked up in the house all day while Alex Kelly is out running around.
You've seen him?
He was at the game. But he didn't see me. I ran out. But you've got to get out, Carrie. You can't let him ruin your life.
Ashley, come on, we're late. Let's go.
Coming. Mark, don't forget I have a meeting this afternoon.
Good morning.
I need the scarf.
I thought he'd go to school today.
I don't understand why they're sending me my diploma in March. I haven't even graduated.
Well, they've graduated you early. Apparently you have enough credits.
But I want to be in school.
You can't go to school, but they will let students and their parents spread false accusations and rumors about you. They are the ones being disruptive. We don't have to accept this.
I got scared. Sorry. It's
all right. Hey. Hey, buddy.
Bet you it's gonna rain.
Yeah, I haven't seen you around much.
Yeah, I've been kind of busy.
Listen, Scott, I need your help. Some detective's going around asking questions. You have to tell him I didn't drive Carrie Roberts home that night. Or I stayed at the party.
I can't do that, Alex.
Come on, what's
this? Sorry, all right? I can't.
What's the...
Take your clothes off.
Trying to kill me again. I always wake up in time.
I know it doesn't feel like it, honey, but you're gonna get through this. I promise you.
Well, it's like that night won't ever end. I hear his voice. I see his face. I can't get away from him. Everybody knows, don't they?
No, not at all. Very few people know. Your mother and I are going to do everything we can to keep it that way. If there's anything you need from me, if you want to talk?
Dad, I am so angry, like I have never been in my life. It scares me.
Don't be scared. Think of it as something healthy. A good way to fight back.
Okay.
Hope you're not too angry to go back to sleep.
Scott won't say anything because he's scared. None of my friends want to get involved.
Hello? No, I have nothing to say about that, and don't call my house again. Damn reporters.
Have you talked to all the other kids at Luke's party?
I told you, Mom. Nobody wants to talk. They're avoiding me. Boy, you sure find out who your friends are when the chips are down.
You're investigating this. What else can you do?
I'll talk to them again. I need to find someone who can say they saw Carrie get into a different car. As Alex is saying.
All right, then find him. And leave no stone unturned. Don't answer that, Melanie.
I will not have my son be made the target of a witch hunt. Surely someone will talk.
I can't tell you how good this felt. Getting out. Thank you.
When was the last time?
I can't even remember. second time the Morrisons have canceled brunch at the last moment.
Can't imagine why.
Some people are pointing at Ashley, thinking she's the one. Oh my God. Oh, Mark, look who's here.
Wonder how they're feeling.
Helen, where's that sheet with the trial dates on it?
Thank you.
Trial date is February 18th, 6 months from now.
And will the cases be tried together?
I hope so. We're still waiting on that. Gary, I have some news that'll make you feel better. Alex Kelly's leaving Darien.
He won't be back to the trial.
Where's he going?
Colorado. Give me a chance to clear my head. Get away from all this craziness. Got a job lined up in some restaurant.
Yeah. Alex Sherman's a great lawyer. You know, he's gonna pull you through this.
Yeah, well, if he's really great, he'll get the cases tried separately. Otherwise, I am screwed. If I lose...
Alex, you're not gonna lose. I mean, you didn't do anything.
I'm scared, Chris. When I was in rehab at Juvie Hall, I heard stories about what they do to you in real jail. There's no way I could survive that.
Thank you. And just so you all know, Carrie made the dressing and the potatoes.
Suddenly I'm not so hungry.
Yeah, I've been serving turkey in the dorm cafeteria. You can still make it, you know.
No, thanks. 2 months of that food is punishment enough.
Well, look, we've got him here. Let's keep him here for a while.
Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Offer thanks for the guidance you've given this family. May we never lose our faith. Amen.
Amen.
No.
I'll be right back.
Snowing that night. It's okay. It's okay. But what if I can't face him?
We'll all be in the courtroom with you. And we'll face him together.
Well, as you know, the judge has decided to consolidate both cases. Obviously, not what we wanted. Now, we can plea bargain. The state is offering you 15 years to serve.
There's no way. Why should I go to jail for something I didn't do?
The deck has been stacked against him from the beginning. This so-called system of ours is not working.
Ricky, speaking frankly, what are Alex's chances?
Speaking frankly, not great.
He was supposed to be here an hour ago.
morning later.
So, Mr. Sherman, any idea yet where your client might be?
I'm sorry, Your Honor. I just conferred with his parents, and they haven't heard from him in the last couple of days. I can only assume he's not coming because he's scared.
Recess the court.
Well, it looks like Alex jumped bail. His parents have absolutely no idea where he is.
He is accused of raping two women in Connecticut. Out on bail, he failed to appear for his trial and disappeared without a trace. Alex Kelly has continued to elude federal and local authorities for over 2 years. He has been cited as far away as Germany and most recently as close to home as Boston. FBI agents are awaiting your call.
There's this great communication seminar on Thursday night.
We'll continue in a moment.
Hi, Carrie. What's wrong?
They said on television that Alex was here in Boston. Is that true?
No. There's been dozens of rumors, and the FBI has pursued all of them, and none of them point to Alex being in this country.
Believe me, I would have called you.
You have to tell me this stuff, Bruce. I don't want to hear about it on TV.
Carrie, calm down.
Calm down? You know what's occurred to me, Bruce? He has to kill me now because it's the only way he's ever going to be free.
Carrie, he'll never be free no matter what he does. And the last thing he would do right now would be to come after you.
Carrie, let me worry about Alex and you take care of yourself. And try not to let this consume you.
I've seen it happen, and you end up losing no matter what happens with the case.
Alex? Alex Kelly? Dude, it's Blair! Chester Arthur High, 85, remember?
Je ne te comprends pas, papa.
Oh, very funny, man. I know it's you. Somebody told me they ran into you. I think it was like, it was Ireland.
Laisse-moi tranquille, huh?
Alex.
Mange la merde, toi.
Alex! I'll buy you a beer!
Oh, fair.
Pardon, monsieur. Good time to do
it. Chris.
Yeah, man.
Is that coffee?
Let me help you with that.
Oh, thanks.
Sure. Are you the one? Mr. Mr. Conqueror?
Oh, no. I'm just the stage manager.
Oh.
It's a good play, though. You should see it.
Well, with a title like that, I think I will. I'm Craig, by the way.
I'm Carrie.
Carrie. Very nice to meet you.
Yeah, you too.
Allons, debout. Debout!
Oh, I had a rough night.
Pardon?
I'm gonna go.
Vos papiers.
I'm going.
Passport.
Oh, hold on. Wait, no, it's, right here.
You've been here, a long time.
Yeah, I'm gonna go back to U.S. soon.
Okay. Monsieur! jeune américain.
Mrs. Kelly.
Mr. Brown, these FBI visits are bordering on harassment.
Oh, I know how painful this must be for you, Mrs. Kelly. But you're not helping him by letting him stay out there. We will find him. Eventually.
Believe what you want, Brown. We don't know where Alex is.
Are any of you aware of the laws pertaining to the aiding and abetting of a fugitive? Well, I suggest you read up on them.
Do you realize we've seen each other almost every day this week? Is my imagination or something happening here?
It's definitely your imagination.
Oh, funny.
It's been very nice.
Well, good. Because I have Celtic tickets for tomorrow night, and I thought, well, maybe you'd like to go. You being a basketball fan at all. Is everything okay?
Craig, there's something about me that you should know. 5 years ago, I was raped. It was pretty bad. He threatened to kill me, and he's still out there.
Carrie.
It's a lot to handle. And if you don't want to get involved, I understand.
Carrie, if you're willing to let me, I might be able to share this with you.
It doesn't scare you?
The only thing that would scare me is the thought of not getting to know you better.
So good to hear your voice. Everything's fine. I'm with Anna.
Darling, I have some very bad news.
Talk to the doctor.
Mom, I can't.
Chris is dead.
What?
He overdosed on his pain medication.
No.
I'm so sorry to tell you like this, honey.
I should be home with you and Dad.
Alex. I just want you to take care of yourself. Okay? Be really careful out there. I love you, Alex.
I love you, Mom.
Alex, what is it?
My brother just died.
Oh, no.
He was my best friend in the whole world. A real rebel. And a fighter. He crashed his motorcycle. Doctors told him he would never walk again. So he enrolled himself in this alternative therapy school. And when they gave him his diploma, he had to limp across this big field to get it. People gave him a standing ovation. I don't know what happened. Maybe if I'd been there.
Will you go back home?
I can't.
It must be hard for you.
I just get so tired of
looking over my shoulder, being afraid.
Alex, I feel very happy with you. You could make a life in Sweden. Find peace, even happiness.
I've got some encouraging news. The FBI just took a statement from a guy who says he saw Alex Kelly in Europe. And it seems they've got enough for a search warrant in the Kelly home. We're going to get this guy, Carrie.
Well, that would be nice.
You're not giving up on me, are you?
I guess I just wish this whole thing was behind me.
I tell you what. You won't hear from me again until I've got something real. How's that?
Yeah, like when the trial's over and he's in jail.
Yeah.
Dear Mom and Dad, life has settled into a nice routine. Anne and I spend the winters in the mountains and the summers helping your family in Sweden. I can't believe it's been 2 years since Chris died. I still miss him very much. I hope you guys will be able to come this winter. It would be great to see you. It would also be great if you could get something in the mail soon. I'm broke. Anyway, 94 promises to be a good year. Next week, we're going to go back to France for some skiing and ice climbing. Sometimes I think I could live this way forever.
A search warrant from the New Haven District Court. Please excuse us.
Okay, guys, let's do it. Johnson, Roberts, upstairs. Pastorates, I want you in the study. Ready? Come on.
Would you mind making sure the Kelly family is comfortable in their jungle room?
Let go of me.
Champagne. Where's my martini?
Dad.
We have some news.
Craig and I are engaged.
Oh, I knew it! Oh! Oh! Happy for you.
Let me see those phone records.
Murray, take a look at that.
Wow. I'd say you two really lucked out, considering you didn't know where he was. Out here. Hey, call our pals, Interpol, someplace called Gladys Holman, Sweden.
Okay, thank you.
Everything all right?
That was Bruce Hudock. He says they're about to get Alex Kelly.
Oh, that's great. I think, isn't it?
I'm not sure.
Vi har en häktningsorder för Alex Kelly.
Tyvärr så var inte här.
Kan du komma in?
Mm.
Hey, I love you. We have every night of our lives to be together. Come on.
Hi, Lima Kazi.
Hi, thanks for coming all this way. I thought you'd be Mr. Sherman.
Well, your parents thought it'd be better to have a fresh approach. Come on, let's walk. So, Alex, why now?
I just got tired of running. Tired of looking over my shoulder. Not to mention my passport's about to expire. But it's more than that. I've seen my parents 3 times in 8 years. I lost my brother. I've nowhere to go.
I'm assuming you've had a lot of time to think about your case.
I had sex with those two girls, I admit that. But I didn't rape them. The only reason why I ran was because I didn't think I would get a fair trial.
The sex was consensual. Alex, I've looked through your reports and I think you've got every chance for a fair trial. And I'm here to find the most expeditious way to get you home.
There's something else. My parents?
No, they won't be prosecuted. The FBI warrant to search their house was obtained without due process.
Well, I guess there's no place like home.
Alex,
Ever been violent with you, Miss Carlson?
Don't dignify that with an answer here.
Miss Carlson, do you think your fiancé is a rapist?
All right, all right. That's enough questions. Thank you very much. Put that camera away.
How much money did your parents send you
here? Now, these two women who are accusing Alex Kelly are liars. And there are no victims here because no crime has been committed. My client is innocent of all charges.
The state requests that Mr. Kelly's bond be set at $2 million because no one can promise that he'll actually be here on the day that we start picking a jury.
As Your Honor is aware, the state constitution dictates that a defendant's bail not be so high that it keeps him in jail, awaiting trial. So we request $100,000.
Mr. Kelly, I do find you a high flight risk, so I'm going to set bail at $1 million. And I'm also ordering that if you do meet bond, you'll wear an electronic monitor and be subject to a nightly curfew.
When I get married, I'm going to specify no towels.
Yes, yes, money.
Yes, do we have to watch football?
Oh, wait, come on, it's the biggest game of the season.
It's such a mess.
Unbelievable.
So you raped her?
No, I did not rape anyone.
Did you ever use violence against them?
Never. It's unbelievable that somebody would... I mean, it's just not real. Why would I rape somebody?
Maybe because you hate women.
Exactly. Oh,
come on, let's go back to the game.
Gary, you must know this story too. You're from Connecticut, right?
No, I didn't follow the the case too closely.
Are you telling us both girls are lying?
Well, I don't think they're exactly telling the truth.
I'm with him.
Correct.
Well, that's intelligent.
Oh, two women over the span of 4 days made these claims, and still you have no doubts. Why?
I love him, and he loves me. We have a life to
You idiot!
Oh, my God.
Now, you see that? If he could get a babe like that, why would he need to go and rape somebody?
Oh, well, that's illegal.
The two girls felt knowing he left the country.
I don't think any mother would expect her child to sit in a cell for 15 years for something he didn't do.
Alex was to include another person in his life, a young Swedish woman by the name of Anna Carlson. The whole world thinks of him as a rapist.
That's not him. That could never be him. That's not the kind of person he is.
They lived together for 5 years.
The American media is very different than the Swedish press. They have hurt me. They have hurt my family, Alex. They asked my father how it feels to know their future son-in-law is a rapist. It is unbearable for them. I still believe, but...
I never dreamed it would be this bad, but I'm sorry. Listen to me. This is the worst part. When the trial's over, we can get married.
Alex, No. It does not feel right to me here.
The Justice Department is still considering whether to prosecute Melanie.
I'm sorry.
But they say they will keep fighting to clear their son. This time, in a courtroom in Connecticut.
Carrie? Hi.
Hi.
Sorry, I got stuck at the office. Big meeting. A big contract. I'm starved. Are you okay? How was your day?
Terrible.
Why, what happened?
They were on national television.
Who?
Alex and his parents. They called me a liar. And my own friends even took his side. And I couldn't say anything. It was like he was in our house. And I had to sit here and take it all by myself.
Carrie, listen. This is a big story. And it's only going to get worse because you can't tell your side. I know how painful this must be for you, but we are going to get through this.
Craig, I know you think that you can share all of this with me. But you can't.
Why?
Because you don't know. It's really hard to explain what it's like to feel incomplete.
Incomplete?
Even with you as a wife.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. You know how much that hurts me. And I know it hurts you too.
That's not what's important.
But it is. And you're always so understanding. You put up with more than anyone should have to put up with.
Carrie, every couple has stuff to work out. You're no different. You know that. I don't care what made you who you are. And you're not incomplete. I can't imagine being with anyone else. You have to accept that. Carrie, please. I need you to accept that.
Erica, what are you doing here?
I just started. A couple nights a week.
Yeah, I can't believe it. How have you been?
Pretty good, I guess. So, here we are.
Yep.
Whoever would have thought.
Yeah, it's funny how things worked out.
So can you hang out for a bit?
Oh, I can't. I have a 9 o'clock curfew.
But don't be a stranger.
Is that the guy that raped those girls?
Yeah, he's
a freak. What's he doing here? He should be in jail.
What?
Saw you on TV the other night.
Really? I wasn't watching.
Aren't you out past your bedtime?
You think I did it? I said, do you think I did it?
It's trash. Let's play some pool.
Hey, I asked you girls a question. Am I guilty or innocent? Go ahead, take your best shot.
Look, we really aren't interested in discussing it.
Why the hell not? Everybody else? You're all a bunch of hypocrites. All of you! Hypocrites! Come on, buddy. I got it. I'm okay! I am okay! So I'm okay!
This is where Ray Marcazzi and Alex Kelly will be seated. This is where I'll start from. This, of course, is the jury box. And this is where you'll be. Do me a favor, come sit in the witness stand.
Oh, Bruce, I don't feel like it.
Just humor me, okay? Now, I brought along a copy of your original statement to the police from 1986. Let's go over it.
I think I know the story.
Well, I'm sure you do, but let's look at it anyway. We'll refresh your memory.
I'll take it home with me. Is that all right?
Terry, you've waited for 10 years to face Alex in court, and you've got one shot at it. One shot against a very sharp lawyer. Now, if you're having second thoughts, you should say something right now.
Bruce, I've read the papers. I know that Alex has been getting drunk, hassling women in bars. He hasn't changed. He's still running. As much as I'd like to believe otherwise, I don't see why he's going to show up this time for a trial.
Terry?
In what promises to be one of the most notorious rape trials of this decade, Alex Kelly, a fugitive from justice for 8 years, faces his accuser tomorrow and faces a possible 110 years in prison.
Kelly will eventually have to face new charges following a police chase and car crash several weeks ago, which left his girlfriend bleeding on the street while Kelly fled.
I should get going.
Look, I never got a chance to tell you about how bad I felt for what happened. How are you feeling?
Better. It only hurts when I breathe.
Erica?
You must be going through a lot.
Yeah. I'm trying to keep everything together, you know? I just want things to be better. You can't blame me if you're mad at me.
How could I be mad at you? I still love you. I will be with you tomorrow.
Good night, Mr. and Mrs. Kelly.
Good night, Erica.
Thanks so much for coming over. You're going to be in court tomorrow.
Of course.
Hi, Dad.
Hey. Just saying goodnight. You ready for tomorrow? Now we'll just get a good night's sleep, huh?
Anything?
Your life, maybe?
Well, we're working on it. It's funny, I was thinking about when you were a little boy, you know?
were a constant joy to me, Alex. You know, I still have those ceramic ducks that you made for me in the bookcase.
I know, Mom, I saw them.
Do you remember all the costumes I made you for your school project? The Bedouins and the Chinese New Year.
You've done all you can.
This day is finally here. For 10 years, I've been wanting to face him. Now all I feel is dread.
Mr. Hudock, you may call your first witness.
The state calls Carrie Warren.
To tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Good morning, Carrie.
What happened next?
I could only see the ceiling of the car. And he leaned behind me and did something to the seat, and he was holding my neck the whole time. It hurt so bad. He told me to spread my legs wider, and that if I didn't, he would make it hurt more. I kept trying to close my legs, and he kept trying to push them apart. He was pushing me so hard that my head would bang against the back of the car door. I need a minute.
Are you all right, Mrs. Warren?
Can you tell the jury what happened next, Carrie?
He took his hand off my neck, started to sit up, and told me to get dressed. I couldn't move my legs, they were numb. So I started to roll to the side and look for my clothes. But he had put a light on and I saw that there was blood underneath me. So I found a scarf or something to cover it with.
And why did you do that?
Because I was afraid that if he saw it, that he would hurt me again.
And how old were you, Carrie?
I was 16.
Now, what were your parents' rules on drinking?
We weren't allowed to drink.
And as a matter of fact, you were 16 on February the 10th, 1986. Correct?
That's correct.
Now, you correct me if I'm wrong, but in the state of Connecticut, that would not be a legal drinking age. Is that right?
That's right.
Now, when you spoke to the police department, did you tell them that you were a participant that night in a drinking game called Quartets?
No.
Any particular reason why you didn't tell them?
No.
I mean, it didn't occur to you that might be information they might want to have.
No.
So at this party, after having these beers, you must have been somewhat high or had a buzz on or whatever the term is.
Objection, Your Honor. Sustained.
If I understood your testimony this morning, while he was holding you, you say that Alex Kelly reached behind you and somehow he did something with the backseat.
Yes, while he choked me, he reached over with his right arm and he did something behind my seat.
He had to make the seat go away.
I assume so, yes.
But isn't it a fact that in order to fold down the seat of a 1983 Jeep, one must first reach over,
objection,
and then maybe from outside the car, you
objection,
press a button, and then you fold the seat down?
Objection, Your Honor.
Sustained. Counsel knows better than to ask a question like that. She doesn't qualify as an expert. Get on with it, Mr. Marcassi.
You did ask Alex Kelly, after this sex took place, if in fact he'd used a condom, correct?
Yes, I did.
In order to determine if you might become pregnant.
Among other things.
But were you concerned about becoming pregnant?
Yes.
By the way, you learned on this evening that Alex Kelly had a regular girlfriend named Erica Hudson. Were you jealous of the fact that you had sex with somebody who had a steady girlfriend and there would be no future to this relationship?
I was raped.
Yes, I know that's what you testified. This morning, that was not the first time you ran through your version of events, correct?
Correct.
And when did you last meet with Mr. Hudock to go through your version?
This past weekend.
In this courtroom?
Yes.
So I could call that sort of dress rehearsal.
Objection.
It was not
sustained and stricken.
No further questions.
All right, go ahead, Counselor.
Lieutenant, would you fold the seat down, please? Using only one hand. So is that possible?
No, sir.
Would you use two hands, please? Thank you. I have no further questions of the car, Your Honor.
The defense tells us that it was consensual sex. That having never had sexual intercourse before, she agreed to go into the back of the Jeep Wagoneer.
So now she finally got to say what she'd been waiting 10 years to say. Well, that ain't true. What she said on the stand the first day of the trial, she'd rehearsed over and over the weekend before. You saw a performance.
So he stops the Jeep. With all the speed and agility that only a star wrestler could achieve, he's on top of her. His fingers are at her throat. She can't breathe. He compels Carrie by force to move to the back of the Jeep.
Remember her testimony. His hand never left my neck. Well, now everybody knows to fold down the seat of a Wagoneer requires two hands.
She agreed to first-time sex on a cold winter's night on top of booster cables in the back of a Jeep with a man she'd only known for a few minutes. Does that seem credible to you?
Well, if she didn't know whether or not he wore a condom, wouldn't that explain to you why she was concerned about being pregnant? And what would you do in that situation? You came from a strict Catholic family with its prohibitions and its rules. So I submit to you that Carrie Roberts lied to her family about what happened, and her family took this out of her hands.
Now, all the little pieces don't have to fit 1,000%. We don't have to prove 1,000%. That's what reasonable doubt is all about.
If this were rape, why weren't the clothes ripped? Why weren't they torn in any respect? And if this were a rape, why were the clothes taken off at all? Reasonable doubt. Ladies and gentlemen, reasonable doubt about what actually happened.
Well, I guess this is it.
We've received a note from your foreperson stating that you are unable to reach a unanimous verdict. Is that the consensus of everyone on the panel?
Yes, it is, Your Honor.
Under these circumstances, the court declares a mistrial. The court is adjourned.
How could the jury not see the truth? What do I have to do?
You did everything you could do. Wish I had some answers for you.
To come all this way. 10 years.
Carrie, if I had a daughter, I don't know that I'd put her through what you went through a second time.
Away with putting me on trial.
It's an unpopular approach, but this jury bought it.
It's like being assaulted all over again.
I find it difficult to accept that this wasn't a star-studded performance by the Roberts, designer suits and all. But to watch a family, they're perfectly coiffed, dressed to kill, they're sitting in the front row, you'd almost get the impression that they enjoyed being there. And if you ask me, they were very unvictim victims.
Bruce, what could we do better for the next time? The original police report does not lie. I did say he took both hands off my neck for a second. What? What's wrong?
Well, there's something else I'd like you to think about in terms of your presentation.
You mean my testimony?
No. Your choice of wardrobe sends a message to the jury how they perceive you.
You want me to dress like a victim?
No, I didn't say that. I just don't think you should look like you stepped off the pages of a fashion magazine. Maybe if you wore something simpler.
So it's not about what I say or what's happened to me. If I dress too nicely, nobody will sympathize with me.
The jury wants to see you. Your pain, how it affected you. Just think about it. Okay?
He's also going for a different jury. He's going to try and find family people and war veterans. He says military guys won't respect Alex because he ran instead of fighting. It's interesting, don't you think?
Yeah.
And now that I know what to expect, Marcassi shouldn't be as scary as he was the first time. Anyway, I think we're going to win this one.
Carrie, have you thought about what happens if you don't win?
Listen, I was wrong when I said that you couldn't share this with me. You have. And no matter what happens, after this, you're my life.
The state calls Carrie Warren.
Right hand on the Bible. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Would you state your name, please?
Carrie Warren.
Members of the panel, have you reached a verdict?
We find the defendant, Alex Kelly, guilty of sexual assault in the first degree.
How did you sleep last night?
Like a baby. No nightmares.
Well, Carrie, you've had your last nightmare.
Can I talk to you? I feel like we've become strangers. Like you're mad at me.
No, Ash. I've just been going through a lot. It's not you.
Are you sure? I mean, about that night. But I didn't go with you to the party.
Ash.
No, really. I think about it all the time. Whether you're angry with me for not going with you. Oh, Carrie, I'm so sorry. There's something else. It kills me to see you locked up in the house all day while Alex Kelly is out running around.
You've seen him?
He was at the game. He didn't see me. I ran out. But you've got to get out, Carrie. You can't let him ruin your life.
Ashley, come on, we're late. Let's go.
Coming. Mark, don't forget I have a meeting this afternoon.
Good morning.
I need this scar.
I thought I'd go to school today.
I don't understand why they're sending me my diploma in March. I haven't even graduated.
Well, they've graduated you early. Apparently you have enough credits.
But I want to be in school.
You can't go to school, but they will let students and their parents spread false accusations and rumors about you. They are the ones being disruptive. We don't have to accept this.
Mom. Carrie, what's wrong? I got scared. Sorry.
Hey, buddy.
Bet it's gonna rain.
Yeah, I haven't seen you around much.
Yeah, I've been kind of busy.
Listen, Scott, I need your help.
Some detective's going around asking questions. You have to tell him I didn't drive Carrie Roberts home that night. Or I stayed at the party.
I can't do that, Alex.
Come on, what's
this? Yeah, sorry, all right? I can't.
What's the...
Take your clothes off.
He was trying to kill me again. I always wake up in time.
I know it doesn't feel like it, honey, but you're gonna get through this. I promise you.
Well, it's like that night won't ever end. I hear his voice. I see his face. I can't get away from him.
Everybody knows, don't they?
No, not at all. Very few people know. Your mother and I are going to do everything we can to keep it that way. If there's, is anything you need from me, if you want to talk?
Dad, I am so angry. Like I have never been in my life. It scares me.
Don't be scared. Think of it as something healthy. A way to fight back.
Okay.
Hope you're not too angry to go back to sleep.
Right, Dad.
Scott won't say anything because he's scared. None of my friends want to get involved.
Hello? No, I have nothing to say about that, and don't call my house again. Damn reporters.
Have you talked to all the other kids at Luke's party?
I told you, Mom. Nobody wants to talk. They're avoiding me. Boy, you sure find out who your friends are when the chips are down.
You're investigating this. What else can you do?
I'll talk to them again. I need to find someone who can say they saw Carrie get into a different car. As Alex is saying.
All right, then find him. And leave no stone unturned. Don't answer that, Melanie.
I will not have my son be made the target of a witch hunt. Surely someone will talk.
Can't tell you how good this felt.
Getting out.
Thank you.
When was the last time?
I can't even remember. Thank you. This is the second time the Morrisons have canceled brunch at the last moment.
Can't imagine why.
Some people are pointing at Ashley, thinking she's the one. Oh, Mark, look who's here.
Wonder how they're feeling.
Helen, where's that sheet with the trial dates on it?
Thank you.
Trial date is February 18th, 6 months from now.
And will the cases be tried together?
I hope so. We're still waiting on that. Carrie, I have some news that'll make you feel better. Alex Kelly's leaving Darien. He won't be back to the trial.
Where's he going?
Colorado. Give me a chance to clear my head. Get away from all this craziness. Got a job lined up in some restaurant.
Yeah. Alex Sherman's a great lawyer. You know, he's going to pull you through this.
Yeah, well, if he's really great, he'll get the cases tried separately. Otherwise, I am screwed. If I lose...
Alex, you're not going to lose. I mean, you didn't do anything.
I'm scared, Chris. When I was in rehab at Juvie Hall, I heard stories about what they do to you in real jail. There's no way I could survive that.
Thank you.
And just so you all know, Carrie made the dressing and the potatoes.
Suddenly I'm not so hungry.
Yeah, but they're serving turkey in the dorm cafeteria. Still make it, you know.
No, thanks. 2 months of that food is punishment enough.
Well, look, we've got him here. Let's keep him here for a while.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And finally, we would offer thanks for the strength and guidance you've given this family. May we never lose our faith. Amen.
It was snowing that night.
It's okay. It's okay.
But what if I can't face him?
We'll all be in the courtroom with you. And we'll face him together.
Well, as you know, the judge has decided to consolidate both cases. Obviously, not what we wanted.
Now, we can plea bargain. The state is offering you 15 years to serve.
There's no way. Why should I go to jail for something I didn't do?
The deck has been stacked against him from the beginning. This so-called system of ours is not working.
Ricky, speaking frankly, what are Alex's chances?
Speaking frankly, not great.
He was supposed to be here an hour ago. Where'd they come without Alex?
Maybe coming later.
So, Mr. Sherman, any idea yet where your client might be?
I'm sorry, Your Honor. I just conferred with his parents, and they haven't heard from him in the last couple of days. I can only assume he's not coming because he's scared.
Recess the court.
Well, it looks like Alex jumped bail. His parents have absolutely no idea where he is.
How soon are we landing in Brussels?
An hour.
He is accused of raping two women in Connecticut. Out on bail, he failed to appear for his trial and disappeared without a trace. Alex Kelly has continued to elude federal and local authorities for over...
I just got tired of running. Tired of looking over my shoulder. Not to mention my passport's about to expire. But it's more than that. I've seen my parents 3 times in 8 years. I lost my brother. I have nowhere to go.
I'm assuming you've had a lot of time to think about your case.
I had sex with those two girls, I admit that. But I didn't rape them. The only reason why I ran was because I didn't think I would get a fair trial.
The sex was consensual. Alex, I've looked through your reports and I think you've got every chance for a fair trial. And I'm here to find the most expeditious way to get you home.
There's something else. My parents?
No, they won't be prosecuted. The FBI warrant to search their house was obtained without due process.
Well, I guess there's no place like home.
Alex,
Hey, Alex. Has Alex ever been violent with you, Miss Carlson?
Don't dignify that with an answer here.
Miss Carlson, do you think your fiance is a rapist?
All right. That's enough questions. Thank you very much. Put that camera away.
How much money did your parents spend in Europe?
Now, these two women who are accusing Alex Kelly are liars. And there are no victims here because no crime has been committed. My client is innocent of all charges.
The state requests that Mr. Kelly's bond be set at $2 million because no one can promise that he'll actually be here on the day that we start picking a jury.
As Your Honor is aware, the state constitution dictates that a defendant's bail not be so high that it keeps him in jail awaiting trial. So we request $100,000.
Mr. Kelly, I do find you a high flight risk, so I'm going to set bail at $1 million. And I'm also ordering that if you do meet bond, you'll wear an electronic monitor and be subject to a nightly curfew.
When I get married, I'm going to specify no towel.
Yes, money.
Do we have much look for it?
Oh, wait, come on. It's the biggest game of the season. It's such a mess.
Unbelievable.
Excuse me.
So you raped her?
No, I did not rape anyone.
Did you ever use violence against them?
Never. It's unbelievable that somebody would... I mean, it's just not real. Why would I rape somebody?
Maybe because you hate women.
Exactly.
Come on, let's go back to the game.
Gary, you must know this story too. You're from Connecticut, right?
No, I didn't follow the the case too closely.
Are you telling us both girls are lying?
Well, I don't think they're exactly telling the truth.
I'm with him.
Correct.
Well, that's intelligent.
Knowing that two women, over the span of 4 days, made these claims, and still you have no doubts. Why?
I love him, and he loves me. And we have a life
together. You idiot!
Oh my God!
Now you see that? If he could get a babe like that, why would he need to go and rape somebody?
Oh, well, that's illegal.
The two girls felt knowing he left the country.
I don't think any mother would expect her child to sit in a cell for 15 years for something he didn't do.
Alex was to include another person in his life, a young Swedish woman by the name of Anna Carlson. The whole world thinks of him as a rapist.
That's not him. That could never be him. That's not the kind of person he is.
They lived together for 5 years.
The American media is very different than the Swedish press. They have hurt me. They have hurt my family, Alex. They asked my father how it feels to know their future son-in-law is a rapist. It is unbearable for them. I still believe you, but...
I never dreamed it would be this bad, but I'm sorry. Listen to me. This is the worst part. When the trial's over, we can get married.
Alex. No. This is not feel right to me here.
The Justice Department is still considering whether to prosecute Melanie.
I'm sorry.
But they say they will keep fighting to clear their son. This time, in a courtroom in Connecticut.
Carrie? Hi.
Hi.
Sorry, I got stuck at the office. Big meeting. And a big contract. I'm starved. Are you okay? How was your day?
Terrible.
Why? What happened?
They were on national television.
Who?
Alex and his parents. They called me a liar. And my own friends even took his side. And I couldn't say anything. It was like he was in our house. And I had to sit here and take it all by myself.
Carrie, listen. This is a big story. And it's only going to get worse because you can't tell your side. I know how painful this must be for you, but we are going to get through this.
Craig, I know you think that you could share all of this with me. But you can't.
Why?
Because you don't know. It's really hard to explain what it's like to feel incomplete.
Incomplete?
Even with you as a wife.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. You know how much that hurts me. And I know it hurts you too.
That's not what's important.
But it is. And you're always so understanding. You put up with more than anyone should have to put up with.
Carrie, every couple has stuff to work out. You're no different. You know that. I don't care what made you who you are. And you're not incomplete. I can't imagine being with anyone else. You have to accept that. Carrie, please. I need you to accept that.
Sailor.
Erica, what are you doing here?
I just started. A couple nights a week.
I can't believe it. How have you been?
Pretty good, I guess. So, here we are.
Yep.
Whoever would have thought.
Yeah, it's funny how things work out.
So can you hang out for a bit?
Oh, I can't. I have a 9 o'clock curfew.
But don't be a stranger.
Is it that guy that raped those girls?
Yeah.
What's he doing here? He should be in jail.
What?
I saw you on TV the other night.
Really? I wasn't watching.
Aren't you out past your bedtime?
I did it. I said, do you think I did it?
It's trash. Let's play some pool.
Hey, I asked you girls a question. Am I guilty or innocent? Go ahead, take your best shot.
Look, we really aren't interested in discussing it.
Why the hell not? Everybody else? You're all a bunch of hypocrites. All of you! Hypocrites! Come on, buddy. I got it. I'm okay! I am okay! I'm okay!
This is where Ray Marcazzi and Alex Kelly will be seated. This is where I'll start from. This, of course, is the jury box. And this is where you'll be. Do me a favor, come sit in the witness stand.
Oh, Bruce, I don't feel like it.
Just humor me, okay? Now, I brought along a copy of your original statement to the police from 1986. Let's go over it.
I think I know the story.
Well, I'm sure you do, but let's look at it anyway. We'll refresh your memory.
I'll take it home with me. Is that all right?
Carrie, you've waited for 10 years to face Alex in court, and you've got one shot at it. One shot against a very sharp lawyer. Now, if you're having second thoughts, you should say something right now.
Bruce, I've read the papers. I know that Alex has been getting drunk, hassling women in bars. He hasn't changed. He's still running. As much as I'd like to believe otherwise, I don't see why he's going to show up this time for a trial.
Carrie?
Promises to be one of the most notorious rape trials of this decade. Alex Kelly, a fugitive from justice for 8 years, faces his accuser tomorrow and faces a possible 110 years in prison.
Kelly will eventually have to face new charges following a police chase and car crash several weeks ago, which left his girlfriend bleeding on the street while Kelly fled.
I should get going.
Look, I never got a chance to tell you about how bad I felt for what happened. How are you feeling?
Better. It only hurts when I breathe.
Erica?
You must be going through a lot.
Yeah. I'm trying to keep everything together, you know? I just want things to be better. You can't blame me if you're mad at me.
How could I be mad at you? I still love you. I will be with you tomorrow. Good night, Mr. and Mrs. Kelly.
Good night, Erica.
Thank you so much for coming over. You're going to be in court tomorrow.
Of course.
Hi, Dad.
Hi. Just saying good night. You ready for tomorrow? Now we'll just get a good night's sleep, huh?
Anything?
New life, maybe?
Well, we're working on it. It's funny, I was thinking about when you were a little boy, you know? You were a constant. To get you to a doctor.
No. Please, I don't want to.
I know. But he may have really hurt you internally. And those bruises.
I don't want to see Dr. Anderson.
No. No, you need to see a gynecologist.
Who?
Well,
Dr. Reston is very nice.
No!
Would you rather see a woman? I'll take care of that, all right?
I have to go lie down.
The doctor said there was trauma to the genital area. Multiple cuts and scrapes. He really roughed her up. It's just that she's such a happy, outgoing kid. I mean, how is this going to affect her?
Are you safe?
Yes.
Yeah, I need to.
Well, bring him with me upstairs.
You feeling better, honey? I know how hard this is, but we're almost done. If you can just give me...
I shouldn't have come here.
No. You made the right decision. Now, if you can sign a complaint, we'll bring him in.
I can't do that. He threatened to kill me. Do you know how close he lives?
Carrie, he can't get to you if he's behind bars.
I know, but I can't. I can't, Mom.
Take a couple of days to consider things, Miss Roberts. When you're ready, if you're ready, you can come in and sign a formal complaint, all right?
Bruce?
Kelly Mann on line one.
Hello?
Remember I phoned you the other day about a 16-year-old who said she'd been raped by Alex Kelly?
Oh, yeah, Carrie Roberts. Yes, did she decide to press charges?
No, but there's another girl claiming he just did the same thing last night.
It's my fault.
It is not your fault, Carrie.
But I could have stopped it. If I'd signed that complaint.
Honey, you couldn't possibly have known.
No. I can't let him do it again.
Hello, Carrie.
I'm ready to press charges against Alex Kelly. For rape. Are you all right?
What?
Honey, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, Mom. I'm glad you both came.
I can only imagine how alone you must be feeling right now. Kind of like the world isn't a safe place anymore. Hmm? It takes a lot of courage to go through something like this. But I want you to know that I'll be with you every step of the way. But I also want you to know that it is going to get rough. But I want you to try to remember, no matter how hard it gets, that I'm on your side.
What's it like to testify in court?
It's just like having a conversation. I ask you a question, you answer. No games, no rehearsed speeches, just you being yourself. Okay, let's talk about... Alex Kelly.
How long will he be in jail? Until the trial starts?
No. A week, perhaps. I did ask for an unusually high bail. Keep him in a little longer.
500,000? Why is it so high?
Well, given last year's difficulties of drug rehab, we don't have a lot of leverage, Alex.
Look, I feel terrible about all this. I mean, just when I thought I had all the bad stuff behind me, now this.
Darling, this is not entirely your fault. Chris took a lot of our attention, and
I take a lot of this blame, son.
I'm just worried they're going to use my past against me.
Well, honey, they don't know you the way we do. The truth will come out, I promise.
If everyone believes those girls, if I can't beat this thing.
But you will, son. You will. We've hired the best damn lawyer in the state.
Mickey Sherman. He's good.
And what do you think our chances are?
Well, we have two plaintiffs with the same story, and if the judge joins the cases together, I think we stand an excellent chance.
We'll get through this. I love you.
I love you too, Lou.
I'm gonna meet her. The other girl.
Well, I'm sorry, but I couldn't allow that.
Why not?
Because Mickey will say that you were comparing stories, that you had done this together. You're going to have to trust me on this one.
I don't want to compare stories. I just want to apologize.
Can I tell you a little secret? I could have arrested Alex a few days ago. When I read your story in the police report, I could have impounded the Jeep, taken him in. But I didn't. I waited, just like you. So you see, we could either blame ourselves, or we can put him away. Together.
Could I speak to Carrie, please?
I'll see if she'll come to the phone. Who is it?
It's Alex Kelly. Please?
Now, you listen to me. Don't you ever dare to call here again. Do you understand me?
That was him, wasn't it?
Honey, it's all right.
He's gonna kill me. He said so.
Carrie, he is not. He's in jail.
For how long?
I don't know how to thank you, Mr. Sherman.
It's Mickey, and thank you, folks. They put up the house, not me.
I still can't believe any of this. I just can't wait to get back to school, get things back to normal.
Right. Yeah, about school, they'd prefer you to study at home for now. They'll provide it to you, just until things calm down a bit.
Doesn't that make me look guilty?
It won't be for long, son.
Morning.
Morning.
Are you going to school today?
No.
I have a math quiz for Spirit.
Should we look? Good luck. Are you? Have a good day.
Honey, come on. You don't want to be late for Dr. Alonso.
Mom, where's the car parked?
Out front.
Can you pull it into the garage?
Oh, Carrie, it's just outside the front door.
Mom, he lives right down the street. Please.
Hey, you know, this reminds me of when we were kids, you know, staying home on snow days.
Yeah. Weren't we drinking milk and cookies then?
Yeah, probably for the last time. You know, I never thought I would miss being seven.
Yeah. Be nice to be a kid again. All those people cooing and fussing.
Hi. You coming in?
Alex, I can't go to the game with you.
You can't?
Alex, I can't see you anymore.
Since when?
My parents don't think it's a good idea. I'm sorry.
Erica, wait a second. Erica?
Where were you?
I think Erica just broke up with me.
You mean just now?
Yeah, but I saw it coming.
Huh. So you go off basketball game tonight?
I don't know. It's gonna be weird being out.
Where do you want to sit, boss?
No way.
Oh, my God. Alex.
Alex. Alex. Alex. Alex. Alex. Alex. Alex. Alex. Alex. Alex.
Ashley, I can't stop him from coming to a basketball game.
Well, you're not letting him back into school, are you?
We haven't made a final decision.
My sister still can't leave the house because of what he did to her, and you haven't made a decision.
Alex! 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 Alex!
Hi. Who won the game?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
Ride's here.
Coming! And I'll be back by 11:30, I promise.
If you're not back by 11:45, I send a search party.
Bye.
Hey, say hi to the gang for me.
You sure you don't want to go? We're going to Luke's after.
I'm positive.
No? All right.
Bye, dear.
Bye.
Have a good time.
I will.
Bye.
Bye.
Have fun.
I will.
I make that same play in practice every time.
I bet.
I do. The coach says I might start next week.
Why do girls play basketball anyways?
Why do guys?
Same reason they play any sport in high school. We get girls.
Please!
started. Come on, Alex.
Hey, come on. Take it inside, huh?
I'm on probation as a teacher. Hold on.
Over there in the middle.
Oh man, it's packed. There's no seats.
Don't worry about it. Oh, look out, here comes the principal.
Hello, boys. Are you going to bring home a wrestling championship for Chester Saturday?
You can count on it.
Heard about the talk you gave to the freshman class last week. We're all very proud of it.
Well, thank you, Mr. Knight. Best way to scare kids off drugs is just tell them what I went through.
Excuse me. Me and my buddies want to squeeze in here?
But there's no room.
Oh, come on. Just give it a try. Excuse me.
Are we going to score yet?
Yeah. We're up by four.
Who's coming to this party tonight?
Usual folks. It's not going to be that big.
Are they ever?
What was it?
Hey, Luke Larson's having a party. You can call it that.
Now let's get some beer first.
Oh, yes! Drink up, Pete.
Chug.
Good one.
You are next.
No, you won't be able to get it in.
Name on it. Here you go.
No way.
I may be a little late. I haven't found a ride yet.
You want me to come and get you?
No, Dad, I can find a ride.
I can be there in 20 minutes.
I'll call you back.
I'll put on a football jersey. They'll think I'm your brother.
Goodbye, Dad. Lisa, I can't wait any longer. I need a ride now.
He hasn't asked me out yet.
I'll give you a ride.
No, that's okay.
She lives right down the street from me.
Yes, no problem.
Why can't you go with her?
I don't even know him.
His name's Alex, and he's all everything at Chester. If you don't go with him, I will.
Carrie, have you met Alex Kelly?
No. Hi.
Hi.
Listen, I can find a ride, really.
At 11:30, she turns into a pumpkin, so...
It's no problem, really. I can drop you off and come back.
See, Carrie, when you're 17, you won't have this problem. Assuming you know how to drive by then. What's the rush?
She's got a curfew.
It's curfew.
Thank you. Yeah.
Call you tomorrow.
It's just here.
Is this yours?
No, it's my girlfriend's parents. They're away in Florida. Let me drive it.
That's pretty nice of them.
Come on.
No, just take me home. Please.
Fine.
Oh, wait, that's my house. You passed it.
I'll just go and turn around.
No, just let me out. I can walk.
No, that's all right. I'll just go and turn around.
Stop.
You're gonna make love to me or I'll kill you.
the back.
Take your clothes off. Take your clothes off. This could be easier. This could be hard.
Why?
I don't know. I couldn't help myself.
If you tell anybody, I'll do it again. And then I'll kill you.
Harry, what's wrong?
Nothing. I had a fight with a girl from school. I can't talk about it.
Hi. Hey. Beer and painkillers are so sweet. How you feeling?
I'm alive.
Hi, darling. How did the game go?
Oh, we won.
Great. Did you do anything interesting afterwards?
Not special.
You ready to go upstairs?
Yeah.
All right. Just lean on my arm.
There. You got it?
You go to bed? Put the lights up.
Tell me what I missed.
Oh, my God.
Carrie?
Oh, God.
Carrie, what? What's wrong?
I can't.
Carrie? Carrie, what happened?
He said he'd kill me.
Who did?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Oh, Carrie, shh.
Oh, my God.
It's okay. I'm here. You're home now. Don't be scared.
Oh, my God.
Carrie, please. Honey, what happened? Can you tell me what happened?
Please. You raped me.
Who did? Who?
Alex Kelly.
What?
Alex Kelly. You can't tell anybody. You can't even tell Mom and Dad, please. You can't.
Okay.
You have to promise.
Okay, I promise.
Oh, God.
Okay, well, Carrie, I'm going to run you a hot bath, okay? It'll help.
Okay.
What?
My back.
Okay. Harry. Okay, take your pants off.
Oh.
What?
Oh, God.
Okay, I'll be right back. I don't know what to do, Andrew.
But where's Mom and Dad?
They're upstairs. They don't know anything. She won't let me tell them. I know, but she won't let me. Alex said he'd kill her, and she's terrified.
Who is that? What are you doing?
It's Andrew. Talk to him, please.
Hey, I'm so sorry. You all right?
No. That was so awful, Andrew. It's so awful.
But you gotta tell Mom and Dad.
I can't. do that.
Okay. Then if it's all right with you, I'll tell him.
Okay.
Oh, no. Hello?
Is this Joe Kelly, Alex's father?
I just got a call from Carrie Roberts' father. She told him that you raped her. Is that true?
What? Dad, are you kidding? No way. I don't even know her. I don't.
I talked to Alex and he denies it. How's your daughter doing?
Not well.
So what are you gonna do?
At this point, I'm not sure. Carrie is extremely frightened because she says Alex threatened to kill her. We're trying to convince Carrie to go to the doctor and the police.
Well, so be it.
Yes, so be it.
Joe, what was that all about?
Mark Roberts is saying that Alex gave his daughter a ride home last night and raped her. Alex denies it. You were asleep.
Oh, my God. Who's his daughter?
Carrie? I don't even think Alex knows her.
Wasn't even in the car with her.
That's a hell of a thing to make up, son.
Yeah, it sure is.
Oh, is it possible that she could have a crush on you?
I wouldn't be surprised. She certainly wouldn't be the first one.
Two years. He has been sighted as far away as Germany. And most recently, as close to home as Boston. FBI agents
hey,
are awaiting your call.
There's this great communication center on Thursday night.
We'll continue in a moment.
Hi, Carrie. What's wrong?
They said on television that Alex was here in Boston. Is that true?
No. There's been dozens of rumors, and the FBI has pursued all of them, and none of them point to Alex being in this country.
Believe me, I would have called you.
You have to tell me this stuff, Bruce. I don't want to hear about it on TV.
Carrie, calm down.
Calm down? You know what's occurred to me, Bruce? He has to kill me now because it's the only way he's ever going to be free.
Carrie, he'll never be free no matter what he does. And the last thing he would do right now would be to come after you.
Carrie, let me worry about Alex and you take care of yourself. And try not to let this consume you.
I've seen it happen, and you end up losing no matter what happens with the case.
Alex? Alex Kelly? Dude, it's Blair. Chester Arthur High, 85, remember?
Je ne te comprends pas.
Oh, very funny, man. I know it's you. Somebody told me they ran into you. I think it was like, it was Ireland.
Laisse-moi tranquille, huh?
Alex.
Mange la merde, toi.
Alex! I'll buy you a beer!
Enfin.
Pardon, monsieur.
You're tired of
Chris.
Yeah, man.
Is that coffee?
Let me help you with that.
Oh, thanks.
Sure.
Are you the one? Who's to conquer?
Oh, no, I'm just the stage manager.
Oh.
It's a good play, though. You should see it.
Well, with a title like that, I think I will. I'm Craig, by the way.
I'm Carrie.
Carrie. Very nice to meet you.
Yeah, you too.
Allons, debout. Debout!
Oh, I had a rough night.
Pardon?
I'm gonna go.
Vos papiers.
I'm going.
Passport.
Oh, hold on. Wait, no, it's right here.
You've been here a long time.
Yeah, I'm gonna go back to U.S. soon.
Okay. Monsieur!
Un jeune Américain.
Mrs. Kelly.
Mr. Brown, these FBI visits are bordering on harassment.
Oh, I know how painful this must be for you, Mrs. Kelly. But you're not helping him by letting him stay out there. We will find him. Eventually.
Believe what you want, Brown. We don't know where Alex is.
Are any of you aware of the laws pertaining to the aiding and abetting of a fugitive? Well, I suggest you read up on them.
Do you realize we've seen each other almost every day this week? Is my imagination or something happening here?
It's definitely your imagination.
Oh, funny.
It's been very nice.
Well, good. Because I have Celtic tickets for tomorrow night, and I thought, maybe you'd like to go. You being a basketball fan at all. Is everything okay?
Craig, there's something about me that you should know. 5 years ago, I was raped. It was pretty bad. He threatened to kill me, and he's still out there.
Carrie.
It's a lot to handle. And if you don't want to get involved, I understand.
Carrie, if you're willing to let me, I might be able to share this with you.
It doesn't scare you?
The only thing that would scare me is the thought of not getting to know you better.
So good to hear your voice. Everything's fine. I'm with Anna.
Darling, I have some very bad news.
Talk to the doctor.
Mom, I can't.
Chris is dead.
What?
He overdosed on his pain medication.
No.
I'm so sorry to tell you like this, honey.
I should be home with you and Dad.
Alex. I just want you to take care of yourself. Okay? Be really careful out there. I love you, Alex.
I love you, Mom.
Alex, what is it?
brother just died.
Oh, no.
He was my best friend in the whole world. A real rebel and a fighter. He crashed his motorcycle. Doctors told him he would never walk again. So he enrolled himself in this alternative therapy school. And when they gave him his diploma, he had to limp across this big field to get it. People gave him a standing ovation. I don't know what happened. Maybe if I'd been there.
Will you go back home?
I can't.
It must be hard for you.
I just get so tired of looking over my shoulder, being afraid.
Alex, I feel very happy with you. You could make a life in Sweden. Find peace, even happiness.
I've got some encouraging news. The FBI just took a statement from a guy who says he saw Alex Kelly in Europe. And it seems they've got enough for a search warrant in the Kelly home. We're going to get this guy, Carrie.
Well, that would be nice.
You're not giving up on me, are you?
I guess I just wish this whole thing was behind me.
I tell you what. You won't hear from me again until I've got something real. How's that?
Yeah, like when the trial's over and he's in jail.
Yeah.
Dear Mom and Dad, life has settled into a nice routine. Anne and I spend the winters in the mountains and the summers helping your family in Sweden. I can't believe it's been 2 years since Chris died. I still miss him very much. I hope you guys will be able to come this winter. It would be great to see you. It would also be great if you could get something in the mail soon. I'm broke. Anyway, 94 promises to be a good year. Next week, we're going to go back to France for some skiing and ice climbing. Sometimes I think I could live this way forever.
A search warrant from the New Haven District Court. Please excuse us.
Okay, guys, let's do it. Johnson, Roberts, upstairs. Ostowitz, I want you in this room.
Would you mind making sure the Kelly family is comfortable in their jungle room?
Let go of me.
Champagne. Where's my martini?
Dad.
We have some news.
Craig and I are engaged.
Oh! I knew it! Oh! Oh! Happy for you.
Let me see those phone records.
Murray, take a look at that.
Wow. I'd say you two really lucked out. Considering you didn't know where he was.
What do we got here? Hey. Call our pals. Interpol. Someplace called Gladys Holman, Sweden.
Everything all right?
That was Bruce Hudock. He says they're about to get Alex Kelly.
Oh, that's great. I think, isn't it?
I'm not sure.
Vi har en häktningsorder för Alex Kelly.
Tyvärr så var inte här.
Kan du komma in?
I love you. We have every night of our lives to be together. Come on.
Hi, Lima Kazi.
Hi, thanks for coming all this way. I thought you'd be Mr. Sherman.
Well, your parents thought it'd be better to have a fresh approach. Come on, let's walk. So, Alex, why not?